Hello, Christian.
Hello.
Welcome to the third edition of the Data Innovation Summit here in Stockholm. We are very pleased to have you with us. Before we go deeper into further questions, can you please tell us a bit more about yourself and your background?
Yeah, I'm an educated engineer, and I worked with technology development, technology management, and corporate entrepreneurship for the last 20 years.
Oh.
And then this thing about data and innovation in data came up, and I had one employee that actually worked as a data scientist, and I thought this is going to grow. So I started to build on that, and today my role is leading a data analytics team in our business development organization in my company, Grundfos.
Yes, and so far we have heard Grundfos is doing great in that.
I think so, yeah.
Great, so as you said, data-driven business and innovation has changed the world, and it's continually doing so. So can you give us some, in your opinion, some interesting examples, how can organizations excel in this area?
Yeah, I think building the examples, organizations need to do that, building the POCs and show the value. But you also need to think about how to scale and how to scale across the business, but also how to scale your innovation when you have developed your proof of concept in the first place. And that will take you into how actually to organize your teams when you're doing that. I think that's really on top of many people's minds today. Yeah.
So from your perspective, what can some of the biggest, most common hinders or challenges that organizations face when, let's say, when it comes to data-driven business, and what are the implications in case these challenges were not met?
I'll say a major challenge is that when you really want the value out of data, you need to work cross-functional.
Yeah.
So it's mm-hmm. it's classical silo thinking, classical clashes between functions, classical the difference between cultures inside a larger companies, but also between companies that. It's a major hindering.
Yes.
And then quality and governance of data is a second big one. Mm-hmm.
So, Christian, you just gave a presentation about driving value in transformation with IoT projects. So, what is the transformative power of these IoT projects?
The transformative power is that for a company like Grundfos, we want to mm-hmm. drive a sustainability agenda, more clean water to the world, and better sanitation. Mm-hmm. And for us, we can have a certain impact with our products, which are pumps, but we can have an even larger impact on those agendas, driving it from the data side and from the application side, because we simply can have impact on a larger part of the systems and a larger part of value chains.
So if you would to make a link between IoT, big data, and looking to the future, AI, what would that be like? What is your comment on that?
sometimes I make an analogy to quality, because if you want to put in good quality, then you cannot take your product and run it by the quality department and they will make good quality. You need to implement quality throughout your organization, and it's the same thing with data. You can't really create things from data if you don't go across the organization, and that forces us to work together, it forces us to collaborate better, both inside the company, but also between companies and organizations. And I think that will enable us to create better solutions together.
So for those organizations that have just started this journey, that are struggling in it, what would some of your recommendations be in order for them to speed up the process in order to becoming fully data-driven?
I would say a trap to fall into is to think too small, so you have to think really big. And get the people on board quite high in the organization, but also make your proof of concept. You need to show the value, and then get the right thinking and cross-functional collaboration in place.
Christian, according to your area of expertise, where do you see the biggest impact of data-driven innovation?
The biggest impact of data-driven innovation, where I work to make life easier for our customers, life with pumps. So that's where I see the biggest impact, because that's what
great,
I'm doing.
Yeah. Okay. Now, what shall we expect from all of this in the nearest future, in the next 12 months, let's say? Where is it going?
I think it's okay to ask for the next 12 months. I think all companies in the machine industry they will have to do this. It will also move to smaller companies, so they will start looking for consultants that can help them. But I think we will see things accelerate. Just like if you look back and see the numbers of participants of this conference going from about 700 to 1200. That's also how I've seen it. But looking a little bit back, I would say the speed of changes in my company has been really, really fast, and I expect that to be even faster. So I expect a lot of change.
Great, Christian. Thank you very much for conducting this interview, and thank you for being part of the data innovation.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Bye.